Go to the Tools panel of Affinity Photo. Select any of the shapes, maybe a star shape, and simply create that. What I need to do then is going to add another shape for my mask, my vector mask. So ellipse tool, create a nice hole in the center. Now, at this point, I think, well, I've got a mask. I simply just drag that down and then, oh, it's not what I want. Doesn't create a hole, which is what I would like to have. So what I could want to do, I want to invert the mask. So Affinity Photo has got no feature for inverting the mask. Would be nice to do. Unless, please put in the comments below if you know a way of doing that. Be really great in the comments below. Always, always helpful to know other techniques to do this. However, this is my approach. I'm just going to deselect the star. I don't want the star. It's become slightly confusing if you've got that there. So I'm just going to go for the rectangle tool now. Now this is a vector as well. And I'm just going to create the vector shape here. Now it doesn't have to be a rectangle. I could select any other shape to fill the design. Just it fills it nicely, obviously a rectangle. Now with that and that, you can select both in the layers panel of Affinity Photo. Now in Affinity Designer, there will be a few more other ways of doing this. But Affinity Photo unfortunately doesn't have all the vector features in the same way. So now I've got layer and geometry, and I'm going to go for XOR. That's the key thing, XOR. So I get now that hole in the center, which is what I want. Now bring back the star. Obviously that covers it up completely at this point. But again, what I can do to get a mask, a vector mask, simply select that and then just drag down. And you can see as you do that, you get this blue line appear. Now I've got the hole. I've got this hole in the center. It's a vector hole, vector mask hole. So I can select that and I can move things around. I can go, also I can just go here to the node tool. So select node tool with that. And you can see you've got the points. So you can just manipulate it. So if you decide, you know what, I want a vector mask slightly different from that, you can move it around. Don't have to, but you can manipulate that. Also, you can go over here to the node tool and you can move it around. So you notice the whole thing moves, but you've also got rotation. You can manipulate the design and cut it off in different ways, but you still got that hole there at the center. Also, what you can do, you can go up here to the star, and like I say, it could be any shape in Affinity Photo, any shape that's in that tools panel over here. If you find this video useful, please click the like button. Also, any comments, any questions, please put them below. And with that selected, I can now move that, manipulate that. And you'll notice here, if I go over here, the move tool selected and lock children. Well, lock children is off at the moment. So that child, and that's the child, this hole, this mask is the child, and I can move it around. If I go over here and say lock children, just click that. Now it's frozen. That hole doesn't move. You might want that. You might decide, you know what, I want the hole there or there. And if I manipulate this further, I can rotate it. That again does not move. So that's a quick way of doing it if that's what you want. Or just deselect it again, lock children, and now it will move around together like that. And you can of course do that. And also at the same time, this is still a live shape. So you decide, you know what, I want more points. You can add more points to the design and then move it around. Also again, you can go over here to the curves and you can manipulate that if you want to change that. Maybe resize it a bit, those sorts of things. Also what you can do, go up here to the star. And again, it could be any Affinity Photo shape, filters, and you can go for a blur, Gaussian blur. And that obviously applied, everything's affected like that. However, you will notice it just suddenly becomes a complete pixel. Maybe it's not what you want. So if you want to keep it, retain it as a vector design, just avoid the filters like that. But you can select that and then go to filter and distort and deform, and that will be manipulated. So you can just create all kinds of weird and wonderful. And again, unfortunately, what happens, that becomes pixel as well. You might not want that. So again, if you want to keep it just a vector, just keep it like that. But what you can do is you can go down here to effects, click there, and then go say to 3D. And there's obviously a reasonable selection of features here. Go for 3D, and you can still do the 3D there. And you see you've got your whole design there, which you can then still continue to manipulate and move around like that.